وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Muslim Ummah follow you, listen you. You are the light and you are the hope. As you know that all Muslims are anger because of the Jewish movie, and you know all the things, 6 points. So I want to ask what banned things we are not take, and my second question is, Amar bil Maruf, ordering for acknowledged virtue, and Nahi Anil Munkar, forbidding from sin, Allah says, and there should be a group amongst you who invite towards good, order for acknowledged virtue, forbid from sin, and these it is that are the successful ones. Ali Imran 104. So in this ayat, what is the duty of Muslims, men and women, or is this the farzi end? Thank you.
Sisters, the question that I mentioned, the 6 points regarding the movie Innocence of Muslims, so what should we do? That's what I said in the beginning of the 6 points, that if all the Muslims jump into it, we should have a specialized group. If we jump into it, if you're doing 100 points benefit to Islam, I'm doing 100 points, if all of us jump, we reduce 100 points to 5 points, and everyone does that, so net result is we're losing millions of points for the progress of Islamic world. So therefore, there should be a specialized group. If you say I should do, then I have to stop my pitch TV, so whatever points I'm doing will go down again. That's the reason I said we should have specialized groups. And as the Quran says in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 104, let there arise out of you a band of people which enjoy what is good and forbid what is wrong. These are the ones to attain felicity. You didn't mention the second part of the verse. So this is talking about full-time dais. And sister, that's the reason based on this verse of the Quran, I changed myself from a doctor of a body to doctor of soul. No, previously I was a doctor of body, I was a medical doctor. I changed from a doctor of a body to doctor of soul. Because Allah says in Surah Fusilat, chapter 41, verse number 33, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ دَعَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ الصَّالِحَاتِ قَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than one who invites to the way of thy Lord, works righteousness and says, I am a Muslim. The best profession according to the Quran is the profession of a da'i. It is better than any other profession of the world. And that was the profession of our beloved Prophet Muhammad. So as far as what should the Muslims do, it is fard on every Muslim at least to be a part-time da'i, if not full-time da'i. First, every Muslim part-time da'i. Full-time da'i is the best, but minimum part-time da'i, that's what I mentioned in my talk, that for any human being to go to Jannah, the criteria to go to Jannah are four, mentioned in Surah Al-Asr, chapter number 103, verse number 1 to 4, which says, Wal Asr, verse number 1 to 3, which says, Wal Asr, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ فِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ.
How do?
That by the token of time, man is verily in a state of loss, except those who have faith, those who have righteous deed, those who exhort people to truth, to dawah and islah, and those who exhort people to patience and perseverance. For any human being to go to Jannah, according to Surah Al-Asr, minimum four things are required: iman, righteous deed, dawah, exhorting people to truth, dawah and islah, and exhorting people to patience and perseverance. You may be a very good Muslim, you may be praying 5 times a day, you may have gone for Hajj, you may be fasting in the month of Ramadan, but if you don't do dawah according to Surah Al-Asr, you shall not go to Jannah. If Allah wants to forgive you and put you in Jannah, that's Allah's prerogative. As Allah says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 48 and Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 116, if Allah wishes, He may forgive any sin, but the sin of shirk He'll never forgive. So if Allah wants to forgive you, if you don't do that and put you in Jannah, that's Allah's prerogative. But in a normal circumstance, every human being, every man, every Muslim man and woman, for him to go to Jannah, should do dawah. At least a part-time dai, whatever to your capacity. Not that you have to give a speech on the stage, it's not compulsory. But dawah one-to-one with your neighbors, with your friends, with your colleagues, with your people at work, in your building. It's compulsory when you're traveling in the bus, traveling on the road. You have to do dawah. It's compulsory. And this, that tamruna bil maruf wa tanha anil munkar, enjoin what is good and forbid wrong. What is your capacity? Whether on internet, whether on email, whether with letters, writing books, giving speeches, whatever capacity, ability Allah has given you, you should use it to spread the message of Allah and remove the misconception about Islam. Hope that's the question.
JazakAllah.
Thank you.